I think quite a few topics that we could cover, but given that we're a short audience here, I think if you have some inputs from your end as to whether there are any topics that you would like to also touch upon, discuss, that would be very helpful.
Please.
Same thing has happened in Karnataka. Now these residential projects that we are talking about, they are very small, they are just seeding projects where, you know, you are giving flavor to the consumer ke solar se kya ho sakta hai. The ultimate aim is to actually move on to bigger C&I projects where the opportunities can be there. But with, first it was UP which did that, then Maharashtra came up. Karnataka Electricity Regulatory Authority has passed the order for gross metering. And in that scenario, I mean, is there anything that you are aware of on a larger platform? Is other than, okay, news mein aata hai, Maharashtra mein people have, bhukh hartal kiya hai for this. But then, what is the, is there nobody to listen to people like us?
It's a juxtaposition, to be honest. The reason is that, see, the couple of considerations when we talk about renewable energy, right? The entire concept of renewable energy has multifold reasons why we as a country should be moving towards. If we reduce dependence on all imports, tomorrow EVs become mainstream, so you don't need to import all you produce through electricity, right? In terms of like the pollution problem in Delhi, in Mumbai, in major cities, it's massive. Renewable energy is a part of that answer, not the only answer. So there's definitely a lot of environmental reasons as to why renewable energy gets pushed. There's some economic and financial reasons also behind it. So we don't import coal from Indonesia or from Australia as well. Try to save our forex. However, the bigger problem lies in the way the power sector itself is structured. Now, power is a concurrent subject where the state, the central government decides certain policies. But the state government also has its own rights on what policies are to be used. There are certain policies which they have to follow, certain things which are left to the state government to decide. So what happens in that scenario is the state can go rogue. Like if you look at Andhra Pradesh, suddenly Mr. Reddy gets elected, suddenly you have 10-15% of the entire nation's renewable capacity at risk, you have big risk of NPAs, power being backed down, it creates a very bad image for the entire country. And until this crux of the problem is not resolved, we will always see this problem wherein central government kuch bol raha hai, DISCOM kuch kar raha hai. Right? Secondly, ek baar humko aur samajhni padegi that open access, bilateral, rooftop, these are all killers of the DISCOM business. The DISCOM actually makes his money through sale to CNI and through sale to residential. Right? They have massive losses in terms of AT&C, in terms of power theft. They have to give subsidized power to large sections of society, which technically the state government should be paying them for. But that subsidy never gets transferred from state government to DISCOM, which eventually gets built into your and my tariff. The way the railways work, second AC, first AC, third AC pays more because they're subsidizing the cost of sleeper class. Same thing is built into power. And as long as you have a monopoly of the DISCOM being responsible to generate the power, transmit the power, do the billing, do everything, why will they allow anybody else to come in that picture?
But then why should the customer
and company should suffer? Because see, these issues are not since hello. These issues have been there way, way back in the past, right? When you started the Electricity Act in 2003, cross-subsidy as a concept was only supposed to be there for 5 or 10 years. But that never got removed. Atalji put that in his act at that point of time, but wo kabhi nikla hi nahi. So unless wo mindset at that level changes, they've been talking about separation of carriage and content. Jahan pe you treat the DISCOM as NHAI, wherein unka kaam hai khali poles and wires business sambhalna. You pay for the cost of transmitting the power from location A to location B based on your voltages. If that is their only business, then you would have a much open market, right? Because then they're not concerned ki power kaun bana raha hai, kaun khareed raha hai, kya bhav mein le raha hai, kaun kya bhav mein bech raha hai. Mera kaam hai khali poles and wires maintain karna, making sure the reliability is there, there's uptime, there's grid safety built into the system. But as long as you are also responsible to generate the power, buy these power from these PPAs, sell this power, make sure you're making money in this entire process, still giving subsidies. You, as EPCs, as developers, as consumers, we will always bear the brunt. And until the ideological shift comes out there, we cannot expect major changes to happen in the system.
So in that case, I mean, just had a thought. So basically, what is happening is that DISCOMs are, you know, DISCOMs in the politics of the nation are actually, because they are subsidizing the farmers, giving them free or near free electricity, you and I are paying more. So that situation is never going to change.
Exactly, that's
as you rightly said into that. In fact, it's a shift of the psychology is required for the DISCOM. If they are genuinely concerned about their profitability, it had never seen in the previous 7 decades of the freedom. When we are looking at their operating style, working style, their time punctuality, all said and done, it had never been. In the event of their monopoly and they are being into the utility, they are surviving again on their salary or again on our income tax paid to them. Otherwise, the per person productivity, if you go by that in the normal course of the life. Right. Yeah, exactly. What
it took
you are
me
saying,
4 months for one side.
It's like either we go to the still western part of the country is better in terms of the compared to other places and all that, but the psychology of the each individual as an employee is required to be upgraded, and then if they talk about the profitability and all that, it's fine. Otherwise, it's like a manifesto of some political party. There are few people who would be just talking about there and all that. For sure, they are going to be retired after 5 years, and for the rest of their survival, they are going to get the pension. Now, why they are crying about this profitability and all that? For that, throughout their 3/4 of their service life had never contributed anything to their fullest ever. Now they are trying to fool others. That's the unfortunate part of it. And now the infrastructure of that grid transmission and distributions are owned by them, managed by them, regulated by them. Even all of PV people intend to do something. We have to, at the end of the day, go to them only and use their T&D line and all that and have to do it. So it's somewhere down the line, just tug of the war or to just share their importance and all that. But I'm sure in Maharashtra also.
Actually, what Modi government is doing is very correct. But our country, as you see, if we want to change one person's one habit, also it is a very difficult task. And we have been under rule of somebody since last 300-500 years. So thinking on our own, even 70 years time is also not enough. So now things are changing fast. But what is common people see as all kinds of compliance as dictatorship. But it is not such that. At everywhere, in all, means base, sub, what I think is the most basic thing is the collection of taxes and revenue. If those things are accountable, black money and everything, all these are coming, means now.
Mm.
करेक्ट सर,
बिकॉज़ इट इज कॉन्फ्लिक्ट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट.
नहीं,
आज आप डिस्कॉम को बोल रहे हो कि मैं ये पॉलिसी अलाउ करूँ कि जिससे मैं पैसा कमा रहा हूँ कोई और आके वो मेरे बिजनेस का एक पाई ले जावे. व्हाई विल द डिस्कॉम बी इंटरेस्टेड?
इट्स बेसिकली,
नहीं सर,
बिकॉज़ द बेसिक प्रॉब्लम हैज टू बी सॉल्व ना. डिस्कॉम शुड नॉट बी इन बिजनेस ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस.
I would like to add that they have already tried to address this time. Last year in Gujarat, it was through JEDA, means it is a nodal agency which only distributes subsidies and gives new schemes related to renewable energy. But harder in that was DISCOM. Now this year, MNRE has enforced all the DISCOMs, said this is, if it is their own project, they will take much more interest, and they are taking also. And we have seen the direct result. Last year we used to pay 4,600 rupees per single phase meter. Now same, within 6 months we are only paying 2,950 for 1 meter, because it's his own project, DISCOM. So changes are happening, but this is so big a ship that you it takes time to change the course. Correct.
Many other, please.
I am quite new to the solar industry, just in 2017 that I have gotten introduced. Now, I come with the background of drones and the data that we collect. Now, the question is, we always think that the customer will buy the system and gain financial benefits. Why hasn't the industry moved towards a rental route policy? Suppose a 600 megawatt residential tender, if there's only one or two companies that go and install this on the roofs, and they pay rent to the customer, like the rooftop owner. So now, what needs to happen for this move to happen? Here, the quality issue gets solved, I think so.
So, if I understand your question correctly, you're talking about a model wherein there are only one or two players, right? And you pay the residential consumer rent for using the roof, and the power supply to the DISCOM, correct?
Yeah.
And why that policy is not come up?
Because, see, that model was experimented in Gujarat itself, in Gandhinagar city. But that was not a very success story, because, means, not in terms of technically, but if you say, agar aap koi rent ke ghar mein aap rehte ho, barabar, तो आप उसमें कुछ डेकोरेशन नहीं करोगे, आप उसको इतना अच्छा मेंटेन नहीं करोगे जितना आपका खुद का प्रोजेक्ट है. तो दैट इज़ व्हाई दैट स्कीम वाज नॉट, मींस इट वाज ओनली लिमिटेड टू गांधीनगर एंड फ्यू इन बड़ौदा, 2-3 सिटीज दे वर सिलेक्टेड, बट दैट वाज क्या कहते हैं, मतलब इट वॉज लाइक लिमिटेड टू अ सरकारी प्रोजेक्ट, इट वॉज नॉट अ मास मूवमेंट.
व्हाट यू सेड इज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग आइडिया, इनोवेटिव आइडिया. इट्स अ मैसिव बिजनेस. And if it has been left to a very few operators, that can be also, tomorrow you can have one more Kingfisher. Kingfisher.
So the players is not a mandatory thing. Here I'm just trying to shift the ownership to the people who install it, they only...
So then what you need is RESCO models... What you're talking about is RESCO coming into residential. And the biggest problem with... Like, we are developers, why we don't touch residential in RESCO. A is that you're dealing with societies, number one. If you are dealing with societies, you know that even to get a simple plumbing problem fixed takes a massive effort. Now you're talking about putting solar. Now, if you move away from metro cities, in most of the cities, people love to the rooftops, kisi ko patang udana hai, kisi ko kuch karna hai. That's a second order. Thirdly, what happens to the society as a whole decides, I don't want to pay this developer the electricity bill. Now imagine going to court with such a society. You have to go to normal civil courts, you can't go to NCLT. Aap 10 saal thoda wait karoge. So there is no protection mechanism as a developer. Wherein I feel confident that if I'm investing X amount of money into this RESCO project for supplying power to society, I will get paid or have protection for my capital. Are you getting my point? So if I have to supply power at 4 rupees, I will. But I need to have some sort of protection provided to me. If I don't have protection, then why would I even get in the business? And until that protection mechanism gets built in, until then you won't see a lot of RESCO happening in residential. And until RESCO comes into residential, you will not see residential installations increase, because subsidy model has been tried for so many years, it doesn't work. It's a broken model, it's a broken system.
Why can't the DISCOM pay you? Why do you have to pay the money?
It goes back to my original point. It's conflict of interest. आप डिस्कॉम को बोल रहे हो कि मैं आप ही के धंधे को काटूंगा और आप मुझे फैसिलिटेट करो करने के लिए. लेट्स सेइंग मी टेलिंग यू दैट यू आर एन ईपीसी, लेट मी कट योर बिजनेस एंड यू शुड बी हैप्पी विद इट. यू वोंट बी. सेम थिंग विद द डिस्कॉम.
थैंक यू.
आई थिंक वी आउट ऑफ टाइम.
या वी आर रनिंग आउट ऑफ द टाइम. सो
थैंक यू सो मच.
थैंक यू.
थैंक यू.
थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर बीइंग सच एन पेशेंट एंड अमेजिंग ऑडियंस. आई लव द एनर्जी, the keenness with which everybody participated. I'd like to really thank you all. I'll request Ms. Mahesh Dhani ji, please present mementos to the other panelists on the stage.